Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be testing out a hairstyling tool called Revlon Salon One-Step Hair Dryer and Volumizer. This has been all over social media and I wanted to give this a try because this seemed amazing and pretty much better than any other product like this. So this essentially allows you to not only blow dry your hair but also style it and give it that blowout look all with this one tool. I am not a hairdresser, but I do like the look of nice hair and I want to have nice hair. So I like to try out products that claim they can give me that beautiful hair style just out of the hair salon, like blowout type of a look. Before we jump into me using the product, let me just show you what this is and walk you through some of the key features. So first of all, this is what it looks like right here. You've got the swivel cord. This is where the actual blow dryer is. And then this is the brush. The thing with this product is that it has an oval brush, which looks like this. So that's like one of the key features. Supposedly you can use this to create different types of looks. Like you've got the flatter side and also more of like a bent side that you can use to either straighten your hair more or give it more like curve and volume. You've got this little guy here that you can hold on to that does not get hot. You've got obviously the handle, and then the only thing you can adjust on here is this slider right here, and it's got the off feature, the cool, the low, and the high setting. Okay, so with that being said, let's jump into testing this product out. So my hair is not wet, it's actually just damp. I do wash my hair in the evening because I shower in the evening, and then I let my hair air dry during the night. So in the morning I just style it. So I wanted to start with wet hair but not super wet hair. Okay, so that's the starting point. I am going to spray some product in it. This is supposed to be like a magical 10-in-1 primer. I saw this on Ulta, I bought it. I don't know much about it. I saw it had 1,000,001 amazing raving reviews, so I figured I'm just gonna, ooh, it smells amazing. I figured I'm just gonna spray this in my hair. It smells amazing. Oh my gosh. I may have overdone this, I don't know. I kind of feel like my hair is gonna be greasy now. We'll have to see. Okay. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so nervous. Last time I reviewed something like this, it did not go over so well. All right, let's give this a little go, shall we? I actually don't even know where I'm going to plug this into. I'm gonna have to figure that out. Okay, step one, got it open. Great. Feels kind of heavy. Not like super heavy, but maybe like 2-3 pounds. This is it. This is the beauty right here. Let's give this a little go, shall we? Okay, plugged it in. Okay, so we have off, cool, low, and high. Let's just test them out really quickly. First, we'll do cool. Low, high. It's taking a little second to get hot, but it is getting quite hot, which is great, because I think the hotter it gets, the more likely it is going to be able to not only dry the hair, but also to like style it and curve it. Because the last product I've tried that was similar to this, it did not do a great job of like drying the hair or anything like that. I think it's because it wasn't getting really, really hot. So I have high hopes for this already. Great. So I'm going to section my hair off. Okay, so I'm going to explain what I'm going to be doing in just a second, so that you don't have to hear the noise of this machine here. I'm going to be using this on high setting because I feel like that's going to be the most powerful setting out of all of these. So let's go ahead and try this out. Okay, one piece of hair done. Does feel very dry. Didn't curl it as much as I was hoping it would, but maybe I'm doing it wrong. I'm gonna keep trying. Right now, what I will say is that I've learned that you have to have your hair brushed really well before starting this, because this has a lot of bristles, which is great because it's gonna grip the hair. But if your hair has tangles in it, especially when it's wet, you just wanna make sure you get rid of those tangles before you start doing this, because otherwise it's just gonna get stuck. And yeah, so note to self. Okay, well, piece one is done. Let's go ahead and continue on. It is getting pretty hot, which is great, but it also is kind of bulky to use it. It's definitely not as like easy as just like a hairbrush, you know, because it's bigger and heavier and longer. It's takes a little bit of getting used to, I guess, but not terrible either. Okay, let's go. We gotta pause for a second. I definitely think it's working now, but I think it works better when your hair is pretty much dry and you're just going over it to style it, not like to dry it. So I think if I were to use this, my hair is already not that wet, but I still would probably like dry to the point where there's only a little bit of moisture in there and then go over this just to style it. That's one. Second thing I want to say is that because it's blowing air from all directions and the air is getting quite hot, I do have it on high setting, but it is getting hot, which I like because it is styling my hair because it's hot, but then also it's like blowing air everywhere. When you have a hair dryer, you can control where that air goes and maybe not like have it go right in your hot ear. Like, look at the difference. It looks probably worse than it is. It's not burned or anything like that. Like, it doesn't feel like it is hurt, but it clearly is hot. However, I do have it on high setting, so if you have sensitive skin or maybe it's just hot and you don't want to add more heat, you know, when you're styling your hair like in the summertime, you can obviously turn the setting to low. And actually, maybe I'll try low on the other side. Let's just do that. The low setting is a lot more comfortable than the high setting. You can barely feel the heat with that one, so great. The only thing is the high setting I feel like styled my hair better and like curled it better. I also want to say that I like this grippy thing because you can hold on to it while you're twisting this brush. One thing I will say so far is I'm kind of confused as how to use the brush. I like the fact that it's oval because I think it's different, number one. Number two, I feel like it can give you different results, so you have like more control over like whether you hold it like this, or maybe you twist it more in different ways. So I feel like you can create a lot of different looks with the oval shape. I'm just kind of confused as to how to use it. Do I like twist it? Do I keep it straight like that? Do I go like this? You know, it's a little confusing to me. All right, so I guess let's just go ahead and do the top part of my hair. I feel like that's probably the more important side. Okay, so let me just gracefully move. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to my beauty channel. I feel like if you have thinner hair, you're going to like it more. Wow, this is already getting curled. This is great. I'm probably gonna try to do with the high setting because I feel like that was giving me a better curl. The only thing, again, just keep in mind the hot air is coming from all directions. So if you do have sensitive skin or it's hot outside, you don't want to add any more heat. It's gonna add heat. Can't seem to get more volume here. Maybe it's because I'm using too high of a heat setting, but that being said, I do feel like the ends are nice and curled in like a blow dry down way. I mean, this is just first impressions. I don't exactly know how to style my hair yet because I got a new haircut, so this is not exactly like the most amazing blowout, but I feel like, I mean, it is curling the ends really nicely. My hair does feel like I just had a blowout. Like, it does feel very like silk and smooth, but also like airy, and you know, that blowout feel. I do think it works quite nicely, and I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest of my hair and show you guys the final finished result. We'll be right back. I mean, I think this looks like a blowout to me. Don't know if it was easier than using a blow dryer and like a brush, but it does work, so good news there. Okay, now I'm going to try to add some volume to my roots. I'm probably going to be using a low setting and then maybe switch to a cool setting. We'll see what works, but I'm going to try to add some volume right here. Actually, maybe I don't even need to do that. I'm just kidding. Okay, so this is the final finished look. I'm still playing around with my hair because I wish these pieces would go back, but they just want to stay here, so I guess we're gonna have to let them be. But anyway, this is the final finished look that a non-hairdresser was able to create with this product using this for the first time. I literally just opened the box right on camera and went at it. So this is the result. My hair does look like it had a blowout, I think, and it does feel like it had a blowout as well. Like, it feels really smooth but also light and fluffy, which I love. Now, as far as my final thoughts on this product after using this for the first time, granted with my hairstyle, because obviously everybody's hair is different, and I think that the results you get from using any hair product, including this one, will depend on your hairstyle, your hair preference, and then also your hair type, how thin or thick your hair is and whether it's straight or curly or whatever. So for me, I do like this product. I think that it does work. Like, it does actually curl my hair, it does dry it, but that being said, I think I would probably use this to finish styling my hair, not to blow dry it, because I think using a regular blow dryer is a lot faster and easier. Again, that's coming from a place of me using a blow dryer for a long time and only using this product once. I will tell you that it does feel a little clumsy because it is, you know, it's not super heavy, but it is heavier. It's not weightless. It is bigger. You are having to do this and it's just a little awkward. So I think I would use this as a styling tool, not as a blow dryer, unless you have really fine hair or maybe short hair. But for me, like, I have a lot of hair, my hair is longer and heavier, so if my hair was wet, it would take forever to blow dry it with this product. Now, it does blow dry hair pretty quickly. My hair was damp and this blow dried it like nothing. But again, like, if my hair was actually truly wet, like, I think it would take a little bit of time to use this product. Also, because this is a brush product, your hair is probably going to get tangled if it's completely wet and not brushed through, which is where I feel like I would want to blow dry it mostly, brush it when it's almost dry, and then finish styling with this guy here. As far as some notable things, number one is you want to make sure that your hair is completely brushed through, because these bristles will tangle your hair if it's not fully brushed. As you can see, I did lose a little bit of hair in this guy, which is not a big deal because I do tend to shed a lot. So I don't think it's this product's fault. I just think my hair likes to leave me. As far as the heat settings, I did tell you that the hot setting, the high setting I should say, is pretty hot. The low heat setting is lower in like the fan level, but also in like the heat level as well. So that is very comfortable to use, but I feel like it doesn't style the hair as well. However, if you want to get maybe like more root volume, lower heat setting may work best, because I know you're not supposed to use a lot of like heat at the roots because that makes the hair flatter, I think. Again, I'm not a hairdresser, just like I think I'm trying to piece things I've learned before. The cool setting has a high fan level, but it's obviously a cool setting, so if you want to like set your hair, that's the setting to use. I don't really use the cool level all that much personally, like on a regular blow dryer or on this, but if that's part of your routine, you can totally do that. I like the fact that it's so easy to use as far as like buttons. There's not like anything else to press besides this little slider thingamabob. As far as the swivel cord, love that because it's so convenient not having to have it like coiled up. However, it does kind of get in the way because like when you're trying to go over here, it does like, you know, get in the way. But I guess so does a cord from like a regular hair dryer as well. I'm still trying to figure out how to use the oval shape. I like it. I think you can create a lot of different looks with it because you have this flatter side and also this curved side. And I think that if you want to create more of like volume, you use this side. And if you want to just like a flatter, straighter look, you use this side. But it is a little tricky to figure out what to use where, because when it's rotating and you're trying to like curl the ends, like for me anyway, it gets a little complicated because I clearly don't know how to use this oval shape, but I like it. That being said though, with this product, you only get one brush. With a hairdryer, you can use different types of brushes and different sizes. So if you want to create more of like a lift, you can use a smaller size. If you want to create more of like this curl, you can use like a medium size or like this kind of size. And then if you want to create like really straight, sleek look, you can use a really big size. So you have a lot of options there. With this, you only get this one size. However, you do have two sides to this brush. You have the flatter side and a curved side, which I like. Sorry for all the hair in it. Don't look at it. And then I also like the fact that it has a knob right here that doesn't get hot. And well, I mean, it's a little warm right now, but it doesn't like, it's comfortable to touch it, and you can hold on to it when you're curling. And then last thing I will say is that the handle does get a little warm, but not uncomfortable hot. So it's not like heat travels all the way down. You do feel it being warm, but it's not uncomfortable to hold on to it. The biggest plus for me, I think, is the fact that you just have this one product. You don't have to have the blow dryer and the brush and then trying to figure out like sectioning hair and stuff like that, because it does get complicated. You have a brush in one hand, you have the blow dryer in the other, and then you don't have a third hand to section off pieces of hair. So for me, having this one product frees up one of my hands to do whatever I need to do to section my hair or whatever else. So I love that. So anyway, take everything that I said in, and this is definitely not for everybody, but I do think that as far as these blow dryer brushes go, this is probably the best one I've used, and I haven't used that many. Yes, but I have used a couple, and this is the best one out of all the ones I've used. So I guess that is it for my video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you did, make sure to give this a thumbs up and to subscribe to my channel for more future videos. If you have this product, let me know what you think of it. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, leave those in the comment section below. And with that being said, I'm off. I hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.